Good morning, students. So today I will start a new chapter which name is triangles. This chapter is very important chapter. From this chapter I think 10 to 15 marks will come in your annual exam. Okay, so in class 9 all of you learn about the congruence of triangles. All of you heard this word congruence in class 7, I think. Congruence, okay. So congruence means what? Equal. So two angles are congruent to each other if their values are equal. Okay, suppose angle A and angle B, and this is the symbol of congruence. Angle A congruent to angle B if angle A is equal to angle B. Okay, that means if the value of two angles are equal, then that two angles are congruent to each other. Okay, two lines are congruent to each other if the length of that two lines are equal. Suppose one line segment is AB equal to suppose 5 cm, and another line segment suppose PQ is 5 cm, then you have then AB is congruent to PQ. Okay, so the congruence of angle is depend upon the value of that angles. Okay, and congruence of line segment is also depend upon the value, that means the length of that side. Okay, so now in class 9 you have to learn about the congruence of two triangles. Two triangles are congruent to each other following some criteria. Okay, so there are 5 criteria you have to learn. So in this class, in first video I will discuss all the criteria of congruence of triangles. Okay, so suppose there are two triangles. One triangle is ABC. Suppose one triangle is ABC and another triangle is suppose PQR. Okay, so first criteria is SAS. SAS is what? Side angle and side. Yeah, so first, the name of the first criteria is SAS. SAS means first S stands from side, second A is angle, and again the second S is side. That means side angle side. That means you have to take one angle in between two sides. So now look at the triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Suppose AB is equal to PQ. Suppose this side is equal to this side. That means the value of that two sides are suppose equal. Suppose AB equal to 5 cm, and again suppose PQ is 5 cm. Now suppose angle B is equal to angle Q. Suppose this one is also 45 degree and this one is also 45 degree. Okay? So suppose angle B is equal to angle Q. Okay? Again, now suppose BC is equal to QR. Suppose this side is 6 cm and this one is also 6 cm. AB equal to PQ, angle B is equal to angle Q, and BC side equal to side QR. Then triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, and this criteria is SAS. Why SAS? Because two sides of a triangle are equal to the corresponding two sides of the another triangle, and the angle in between that two sides is equal to the corresponding angle in between the other two sides of the triangle. Okay, corresponding, then you have to remember that word corresponding. That means AB is equal to PQ. You take AB equal to PQ. You cannot take AB equal to PR or AB equal to QR. Okay, corresponding AB is this side, so you have to take the same side PQ, this one, corresponding side. If you take BC, then you have to take QR. If you take AC, then you have to take PR. Okay, so corresponding side AB is this one, PQ is this one, corresponding side. Again, BC is this one, QR is this one, corresponding side. And in between that two sides, there is an angle B. That B angle is equal to the Q angle, which angle is again in between that two sides. If the angle B is equal to the R, you cannot say that SAS. Clear? That means if if two sides of a triangle and the angle in between that two sides equal to the another two corresponding sides of a triangle and the angle in between that two sides, then the two triangles are congruent to each other. Okay, and that criteria is known as SAS, that is side angle side. Clear? Now, if two triangles are congruent to each other, then the remaining corresponding parts are equal. So, in this case, we prove that these two triangles are congruent. Using which one? This side, this angle and this side. This side, this angle, that means AB, PQ, AB, angle B and BC. PQ, Q, angle Q and QR. So, remaining corresponding parts are what? Angle A and angle P. Angle C and angle R. And side AC and side PR. That are the remaining corresponding parts. So, angle A is equal to angle P. Angle C is equal to angle R. And side AC equal to side PR. They are all known as corresponding part of congruence triangle, short form is CPCT. Clear? Corresponding parts of congruence triangle. So this is the first criteria of congruency of two triangles. Clear?